Humans and dogs have a very similar, yet very different anatomy, specifically when it comes to the digestive system. Similarly, we both eat food, absorb nutrients from the food, and then get rid of the waste. Humans and dogs both start with the mouth in order to physically break down the food we're consuming from big pieces to small pieces through the process of chewing. The main difference between humans and dogs here, besides the amount of teeth, is that dog teeth are pointier, leaner, and sharper, specifically designed to puncture, rip, and tear raw animal tissue, as canine diets have been primarily carnivorous prior to the man-made invention of consumer dog food. Also, unlike humans, dogs can only chew up and down, which aids in the slicing and cutting of meaty tissue. Something you may have noticed about dogs is that they eat quickly. They can do this because their mouths produce a constant, excessive amount of saliva that lubricates their mouth, esophagus, and food. The food then lands in the dog's stomach and is broken down by hydrochloric acid. A dog's stomach acid is much stronger than a human's, measuring acid strength from 1 through 7, with 1 being the strongest,
and a healthy dog's stomach acid has a pH level of 2 or lower,
similar to that of white vinegar.
A human's food moves from the stomach to the intestine in 4 to 6 hours, where it takes up to 12 hours to happen in dogs.
This is because a dog's stomach works as a battery reserve, releasing energy to the body only when needed. Once inside the intestine, the remaining nutrients are absorbed, with a total time to pass for a dog between 6 to 8 hours, where it would take over a full day for it to happen in humans, as our intestinal tracts are much longer than theirs. A short intestinal tract is a key characteristic of a carnivore's anatomy. Vomiting is something dogs do randomly from time to time because of their short digestive tract, and does not necessarily indicate a problem. It is common for dogs to regurgitate from eating too much too quickly, and also common for them to try and eat it again.
Finally, the waste is evacuated through the excretory system,
something humans and dogs have in common. Similarly, when we or our dogs consume a new food, there tend to be changes in our waste output. This ranges from changes in texture, color, and even odor, which is all a normal reaction to consuming a variety of foods. A few key differences we have from our dogs: the amount of food we consume is based on our age, body size, and activity levels. Dogs sleep an average of 12 to 14 hours per day, and often only eat 1 to 2 meals per day. This is all because they metabolize their food and use their energy differently than we do. It's even normal for some dogs to fast for 1 to 2 days between meals. Dogs do not have a dietary need for carbohydrates because they derive their energy most efficiently from proteins and fats. The digestive enzymes in a dog's digestive system are made to break down meat. They can break down carbs, but they don't necessarily have a need for them. Knowing how the canine digestive system works, here's what we like to see in our dogs' diets: rotation of lean meat cuts from poultry and ruminants, organ meats including liver, kidney, spleen, and pancreas, fresh oily seafood like sardines and anchovies, eggs, raw poultry bones for calcium requirements, and a small amount of colorful fruits and pre-cooked veggies. Our dogs can eat the same fresh foods as we do, but it's important to understand that their bodies digest food a bit differently than we do. The good news is, feeding real food is easier than you think. Read more at canine.care. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more canine educational videos,
and enjoy your dog food. Have a nice dog.
Okay, love you, bye.